Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas and here we have once again this character, the Warlock 2, didn't survive. Level 49 Warlock class, this is a hardcore one as we can see up here, and I am here in the big boss of the vanilla game without Ashes of Malmuth expansion and without Atlantis expansion. Here we are for the first time ever. I will go in there and I will try to reach the boss and of course defeat the boss. Let's see if we can do it. Of course, as I mentioned before, this is hardcore. I have never died before with this character, of course. And let's hope that this will be true after this boss fight as well. I wouldn't want to see my character getting killed now, at this point. Now, for this boss fight, I think this boss fight deals lots of fire damage and also chaos and some physical. And of course poison. My resistances are not that bad. My poison resistance is 77%, almost 49%, but since I'm using all the time the blood of Trick, it goes up to 77 because of the skill. My chaos resistance is good enough, at least for veteran, 61%. Fire resistance is perfect for now. Physical, when it comes to armor, I'm okay. For veteran, I think this is okay. Armor, it is just okay, nothing special. And I think I can do it, I can survive, but we will see. First, I have to pass through these places. We have to fight at least two smaller bosses before we encounter the big one. Let's zoom out. And this is going to be interesting now. Okay, we can see this guy was trying to hit me. He hit me with melee attacks a couple of times. I didn't lose too much health. This is very good. When you play hardcore, you need, of course, one of the most important things is your health. You need to fight items or to use skills that provide you with many health points, and you also need to fight items or use skills that provide you with many resistances if you want to survive, of course. And this is what I tried to do here. So let's go down. We have some enemies here to destroy. The good thing so far with this build is that I'm using a couple of skills that give me back health. For example, the skill I'm using, my main skill, is this Chaos Ray skill that you see right now. This one initially does not provide any damage converted to health or life leads and things like that. But when I use it, I have attack damage converted to health. I have it because I'm using this offhand. This offhand says 6% of attack damage converted to health to Albrecht's Aether Ray. Albrecht's Aether Ray is this one, the skill I'm using. But since I'm using this one here, this is the modifier for the skill. This one modifies the Aether damage, it converts the Aether to Chaos damage, and this is why now the Albrecht's Aether Ray deals Chaos damage instead of ray. And this is why the chaos damage is the ray now is a red color, or because of the chaos damage. My pet is dead. My pet dies very often. I haven't spent any more points. I have only 1 point on the pet and 1 point here. I need to put more points here for the pet to survive better, probably. But so far I was trying to level up and max out my masteries. I wanted to trigger this skill. This skill is very important for this build. And also because of the 2% damage absorption, this helps very much in general with survivability. So this is one of the bosses, the minor bosses. Let's see, will I survive or not? Okay, I don't see any problems here for now. I'm standing on top of the poison, which is not a good idea. But with the poison resistance that I have, we can see that I do not really have any problems standing on the poison of this enemy. And my pet is dead again. Okay. This is a good sign. This is a very good sign. If this boss died that easily and its melee attacks didn't really do any real damage on myself, this is a very nice sign for the future. These enemies are super easy. We don't have any problems here. This is a torch. We go here and we open up the containers. The next mini boss of this area before the big boss is harder though than this boss here. It is much harder, I would say. So in that boss fight I have to be careful, to be really careful. That boss also summons a couple of other enemies. Tough enemies sometimes, it depends on your build. And I think that for that boss fight, before the big boss fight, I will have to drink maybe this ointment, which would give me more chaos resistance. I have 61, with 25 it would go up to 80% at least. 80% plus something maybe. Which is awesome, of course, at least for veteran difficulty. Okay, this guy is hit very nicely. I was a bit afraid there. Okay, we have some tough enemies. Nice. Okay, the melee attacks of these enemies do not really deal any damage. This is very good. This is very good because the final boss summons enemies of this type all the time, and we could say that these enemies right here, right now, hitting me is something like a test for the boss fight to come. A test to see if I can survive in that boss fight. Let's go this way. I will also explore the whole map. It is not a very big map after all. The second map is a bit bigger maybe, I think. Okay, I'm losing health here. This is a hero enemy. This is a chthonic enemy. Chthonic. And you always have to remember in this game, even if you have your resistance is maxed out 80% or even more, bosses, especially bosses, many times they reduce your resistances. They use some abilities on you and they reduce your resistances. And this way, of course, what happens if they reduce your resistances? They deal much more damage now to you and they can kill you much easier. So even though you have your resistances maxed out, you have to be careful. And also you have to be using ointments, because they provide even more resistances of the types of damage that bosses deal. But you have also to know what types of damage the bosses do. And this way you can use the right drinks, ointments, and you can have a better chance of surviving. And here we have... one of the items I'm using currently is this one. Ring of Steel. It comes with the skill Ring of Steel. This skill is amazing. because it has only 5% chance when hit to trigger, but if you get many enemies, coming at they attack you at the same time they hit you, this one triggers quite often, which means it stuns targets for 1 second. Okay, 1 second is not a long duration, of course, but it is still super very helpful. Very, very helpful. So I'm going to be using this item in this boss fight. This is the second floor of the map. After this floor, we will meet the big boss. Let's hope that we can defeat the boss here of this floor, because on this floor we have another boss. The boss that is even harder than the previous boss of the previous floor. That was scary. Okay, Giant's Blood has reached rank 2, very nice. This is a very nice skill. It is a survivability skill. It helps you very much with survivability. And it is a new skill that I have applied on my build. It is a it comes from a constellation. And it helps very much. So, for a hardcore build, we try to stack as much health as possible, as soon as possible. And also, we try to stack as many resistances as possible. Again, as soon as possible. And to do that, we use different items, we use keys, we use constellations, and of course we use ointments, and also we use components. Very, very nice. Yeah, I can honestly say that this item here keeps my build alive. This item is amazing for this build because of the attack damage converted to health that it provides to my skill Aether Array, and of course many other stats that it provides, such as health, spirit, you know. Super important. I got this item. This one is a mastery frequent. Yes, I think it is a mastery frequent. Or maybe it isn't, but I'm not sure. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I got it from the big boss, the amalgamation boss, which is a big boss that you defeat for Homestead, that area. That one is supposed to be the third act of the game. So, the final boss of the third act of the game. If that makes any sense. Yeah, these harbingers are the enemies that the next boss spawns, summons, and I have to be careful. I don't want to get killed by these enemies. These enemies probably have a very good chaos resistances because my main damage type is chaos, and as we can see, when I hit them, I do not kill them very fast. They have, of course, a bigger health pool than these small enemies here, but still they should have good chaos resistances. And I'm not sure how well this skill will work against the last boss, the big boss of this area, but we will find out very, very soon, I hope, if I won't get killed by the the smaller boss of this floor. Let's see. We are getting very close to that boss. Wow, this is a hero enemy. Okay. Hero enemy is already down. Very nice. Yeah. Okay. So far, so good. My pet is dead again, but I'm still very much alive, and I see that everything is going fine here. Of course, I have to be super careful. I don't go to underestimate my enemies, because every time I have a very good build and going on it, I don't get killed for many hours with that build, then I start underestimating my enemies, and at one point I get killed. And I cannot have this thing here, because this is hardcore, it is not softcore. Yeah, let's pick up items, we will sell these items later. Let's go this way. My pet is still alive. Yeah. I would like to explore and go and kill them all. Especially in hardcore, I think that it is better to explore the whole map before you go and explore the rest of the game. Explore everything and kill everybody in your way. This way you will gain more XP and you have better chances to get good loot, which of course will help you in your journey. So you shouldn't really rush when you play hardcore, especially if you are new players to this type of games. You should never rush. Take your time with hardcore and be careful. Here we go. We are very close to the next boss fight. Now, another detail that we have to remember is this one. This item provides only 6% of attack damage converted to health, to the ray that we use, the skill. 6% of attack damage is a small number, at least at this point, with the damage numbers that we deal at the level of the character and all of these things. But let's not forget that this skill hits, it can hit multiple enemies in a row. For example, if you have 10 enemies here in a row, you aim at the first one and you hit all of the enemies at the same time. And this 6% works at the same time on all of the enemies. So if you have 10 enemies and you hit at the same time 10 enemies, you will take back 10 times 6% of attack damage converted to health. This is very important. So when you play with such a build, you want your enemies to be in a line, maybe in a straight line. Like this, something like that. Yeah, because this is better for you, for your survivability. You get the most out of this item this way, if you hit your enemies when they are in a line. Okay, let's go to this corner, explore this corner, and then we are ready to go to the boss fight, the small boss fight, and after the small boss fight, we can go to the big one. And hopefully not get killed. Yeah. Okay, there is nothing there. I can pick up this thing to sell it. Also, these things can hit you sometimes. I don't know why they hit you. Okay, this is the boss. Let's go, let's see. Can we survive this fight? Here comes the first Harvester. This boss is a smart one. When I cast my spells on him, he tries to run to go to a different place. But still, I think I can do it. Another thing that you have to remember for this game, if you are new to this game, is that bosses, usually bosses are big bosses, and this is not a small boss. It is not a big one, but not a small either. When they are close to dying, they release some powerful attacks many times, many bosses. So Don't think that having the boss almost killed, this means that you have won the battle. No, you have to be careful until the very last moment of the battle. Yeah, the boss is down, okay. Actually, this boss was a challenging one. It was not easy. My pet is dead again. Let's go here. We have a couple of more enemies. And I see an item on the ground. And a container. Nice. Okay, so this is the room for the boss fight. Now, let's go here. Let me check. Cold resistance, no, okay. Royal Jelly, Death Whisper is vitality. This one is defensive ability, I have it already. Okay, so I will, even though my fire resistance is 80%, which is awesome for veteran difficulty, I will still drink one flame drinker, which gives more fire resistance, because it also gives a reduction in burn duration, which is good to have. Just to be sure that fire attacks will not kill me. Just to be 100% certain that I will not have problems against fire attacks. I'll do the same with Bloodhound Ointment to get this 25% chaos resistance. From 61 it will go up to 80 plus something. I will use the Royal Jelly Essence, which will give me more energy and also more health. More health, more survivability. And at the same time I will use this one, which gives health regen. There is also another higher tier of this Royal Jelly, which gives, I think, plus 15 health regen per second and also plus 20 health regen. I don't have these ointments right now with me, so I will use what I have. I think I don't have them. Wait, yeah, I don't see. My poison is okay. I could also use this one to get more poison and acid resin. Yes, let's drink this one. Now, use this one. Use this one, and this one. As we can see, chaos is 80% now. This remains 80%, but plus 51% over maximum because of the drink. 79% without having activated this one. If I activate this one, it goes up to 80% plus 27 over maximum. And I think we are good to go. I gained more health points. Now I have health regen. This drinks last for 450 seconds, which is something like 6 minutes and something. I'm not really sure, I don't remember. 9 minutes, I think. So let's go, let's try to focus, concentrate, and let's go. You have to be careful when you go and fight a boss. Be prepared. Do not just go into the boss fight like that. I also have the tinctures with me. Opa, that was very scary. Okay. One third of the health of the boss is down. Now we have this enemy here. This is a hero enemy. This is bad news actually. I have to run away and start hitting them all with my Aether Ray, because the Aether Ray has a long range of attack, so I can hit at the same time these enemies and the boss. My pet is dead. Let's summon again the pet. I'm doing a very good job so far. I activated my Mirror of Ereoctis, which gives me immortality for about 3 seconds. Everybody's dead except for the boss. Even my pet is dead, but I'm still alive. And I feel like I can win this battle. More enemies are coming out, but the boss is at his final state. The boss cannot really defeat me. I activated my Mirror of Ereoctis once again to survive. Let's go here and destroy these things while hitting the boss at the same time. And here we go. Yes. We did it. This is it. And we still have the potions, ointments, drinks, call them however you want, active. So, that was a very nice battle. We had to be careful. Of course, the battle felt a bit easy, but some of the attacks of the enemies were scary enough. And this is why I was using the Mirror of Ereoctis, which gave me immortality for 3 seconds. And of course, at the same time, don't forget that I was using this skill, Sigil of Consumption. This one deals damage to the enemies that it hits, and also it gives you back health because it has the attack damage compared to health. I was casting this one all the time here, below the boss. And it was active and it was helping very, very much with my survivability. So, I had one source of giving back health, attack damage compared to health, the Demon's Breath skill, which is this one. This one. It has a very nice long range of attack. You use it on the boss, you get back health or any other enemies. I had the Sigil of Consumption, which is very important for survivability on the boss below, down there. It was hitting the boss, it was giving me back health. I had the Blood of Drake, which when you trigger, you get back some health. It restores some health for you. 14% health restored. So, it was restoring my health when I didn't have my health bar full. And it was also activating for me Acid Retaliation, Health Regeneration. And of course, this one reduces resistances of enemies to the types of damage that we deal with this build, that we could kill enemies faster this way. And of course, let's not forget once again the Aether Ray skill, which with this item here, 6% of attack damage converted to health to Aether Ray skill, we were hitting enemies all the time, and all the time we had attack damage converted to health working for us. And this was a combination of skills and items and ointments that helped defeating this boss. So, guys, this is it. We did it. For the first time in my life, I defeated this boss in Hardcore in Veteran. Because I have never really played Hardcore before. Yeah. So, we are going to be having more videos of this guy coming super very soon in the channel. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned. More content, much more is coming, and more projects are coming very soon. I will see you very soon. Have fun, whatever you do.